beyond amazing to me, beyond amazing. Thousands of trails per day. Nobody looks up. Nobody talks about it. Nobody sees them. Point them out to them. Try to show them. They don't want to see it. They don't want to know about it. They're really quick to tell you that you don't know what the fuck you're talking about, and they'll turn on the weather channel. But it's very easy to see. Phone so I can. Oh, I don't have my phone. Watching these trucks drive by all day as I'm driving around and stuff, you know, I figure I had muscle cars and stuff all my life and 8-cylinder engines, and I was complaining about it for a long time ago, even at $2 a gallon, $2.50 a gallon, I was complaining about it. You know, your vehicle only gets anywhere from 9 to 12, 15 miles to the gallon or so. Especially some of the cars that I had. So if you get on them a little bit, or if you got a load that you're carrying in a truck or something, 150, 200 bucks a week. A week. Talking 700, 800 bucks a month. When I was working in Mass, I mean, working in Connecticut, living in Mass, that was a chunk of change even with a four-cylinder. It made it very non-economical. It wasn't really good. It's a big deal. So I had a fucking job. So I had a decent job, decent pay, I should say. It wasn't a decent job, but it was a decent pay. And even that, that's only from a poor person's perspective that the pay was decent. Anybody that liked to be wealthy, they would not have been satisfied with that amount of money. Then you take away babysitters, nanny care for the time that you're on the road driving back and forth. You got 4 to 6 hours a day of travel time, wasted time. And sometimes I'd be working up in New York and have to swing back through Connecticut and everything like that before I headed home. And it's fucking a lot of driving, man. A lot of, nowadays, forget it, with the gas like it is now. And, you know, I was telling people before Biden even came in, just like, you know, it's not psychic ability to predict these things are going to happen. We're told that they're going to happen. The same way that I'm showing you the trails that are in the sky right now. I can't call them, even if I call them mineral streaks, even if I use my name, my terminology, mineral streaks. They've got such a hold on everything, man. My videos get deleted from the beginning, right from the start. That's been happening. Videos get deleted. People break into the channel and delete videos. But now it's even worse. Now I got YouTube just coming out and deleting them right off the bat. They can label them as misinformation, disinformation, whatever they want. Fucked up. Can't really talk about anything. It's even worse than before. Anything that I talk about, I have to make sure I form things and say them in a form of a question rather than stating obvious facts. Because they'll also delete my videos, misinformation, lock me out of my channel, all that kind of shit. So without being able to talk, I've been trying to show people the mineral streets for, you know, a long, long time. 14 years or so now, maybe longer. And nothing, man, nothing. You know, a lot of the guys I used to work in construction with and shit, I was amazed. I'd be like, you guys never look up at the fucking sky to see this? You never noticed this? You know, that's just the trails. I'm not talking about the imagery that I'm extracting from them right now. The imagery that I'm extracting, that's the evidence of the true creator. I mean, so if I'm not even able to get them to acknowledge that we control the weather using these mineral streets by dumping all the heavy metals and carbons in the air, atmosphere, where we want them, and all that kind of shit, you can just see it with your own eyes. You don't need to wait for the United Nations to drop a conspiratorial, many, many millions of conspiratorial. I mean, shit, man, they already had their conspiracy sites all set up, you know, right at the beginning. It's amazing to me that it's like this, you know? And I watch all the people walk by, drive by, as I'm filming it, and nope, they will not look, man. You say, okay, well, maybe they just don't see it, so I'll show them what we're looking at. Nope, they run away. No fucking way, man. It just spins you around, man. It makes you dizzy. It's like living in a Twilight Zone episode. And there are so many things to talk about and discuss with all this, and you can't anymore, you know? Even if the message only got through to a few people over the years, out of those few people, if only one of them is a real person and the others are just psyop, sabotageurs, saboteurs, you know, if that's the case, that's really bad. And then if the one person that you, that have got, that has it, that gets it, is too afraid to go anywhere with it, or doesn't know what to do with it, or refuses to continue looking themselves, then you're back to square one. And, you know, was it a waste of 4 or 5 years? In the case of the Mineral Streets, 15 years? Not really, because I really just try to stay calm about it all, and then is one big thing. Just, what are you going to do? You know, what can you do? Anything you try to do, you know, overly dramatic, anything overly dramatic that you think that would wake people up is useless, doesn't work. Anything that, if you try to think to yourself, okay, entertain them, they all want to be entertained, so do what you're doing now, just be more entertaining about it. Nah, that's just going along with their scheme. That's going along with their scam. I don't believe in that. I don't think that I should just be, I think you should laugh at the entertainment aspect of it and say, fuck you. That's how you sucked us in the first place. Convincing everyone that they were just being entertained. Just enjoy yourself and enjoy the entertainment. That was a trick.